वेलकम बैक दोस्तों। सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन सर्टेन इंपॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर्स, राइट? सो टुडे वी विल बी डीलिंग विद द सेम इन इन द एनवायरनमेंट एंड इकोलॉजी, राइट? सो लेट अस गो हेड एंड सी। सो एज आई सेड इन द अर्लियर क्लास, सो आई विल बी ब्रिंगिंग यू द मोस्ट फोकस्ड एरियाज फॉर द यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स 2020, एंड वी विल बी डीलिंग विद सर्टेन एमसीक्यूज इन द यूपीएससी फॉर्मेट। सो एज वी सीन सर्टेन एमसीक्यूज, राइट, इन द लास्ट क्लास। सो वी विल बी ऑल्सो डिस्कसिंग वेरियस टिक डम्स दैट विल बी गिविंग यू सर्टेन edge from compared to the other candidates, right? So let us go ahead and see the topics for the day, right? So today also we are dealing with international organizations and conventions. Today we'll be seeing about the sites and the certain kind of cooperations in the environmental aspect. There is the South-South and Triangle Cooperation. We'll be see dealing with the Basel Ban Amendment, and we will be seeing with the IPCC special reports that are recently news. We'll be dealing with the World Energy Council and Kigali Amendment to the Montreal Protocol. Okay, so let us see one by one. So the first topic is sites. So there was a recent Washington Convention in the sites. So in this convention, what happened is there was a resolution for the Japan and EU, so to close their domestic ivory markets. So however, this was not adopted. Why this is important? Because it is continuously providing opportunities for the criminal syndicates to traffic ivory, right? So this was in the current affairs. So let us go, see certain basics of this. So CITES, it has its inception in IUCN. IUCN, you know, stands for International Union Conservation of Nature, right? So CITES is a legally binding one, right? So it's a legally binding agreement. However, so it is up to the particular nations whether they can take it as a domestic legislation or not. However, it is legally binding. So, and what does its CITES exactly do? So see, what the CITES stands for? It is a convention on international trade in endangered species. So it restricts the trade of these endangered species, which is it might be flora or a fauna, right? So this is administered by UNEP. Now let us go ahead and see some previous MCQs regarding the same. So in 2015 there was a question. So here you see, let me read you the question. With reference to the IUCN and CITES, which of the following statements are correct? So the first statement say IUCN is an organ of United Nations, while CITES is an international agreement between the governments, right? So the second one says IUCN runs thousands of field projects around the world to better manage natural environments. Okay, this is very much close, and yeah, it's true. And the third statement says CITES is legally binding on the states, but this convention does not take the place of national laws. Okay, it's not like a overriding thing. So it is not like a overriding thing. So however, see, now we have to consider the first one, first option here. So IUCN is an organ of United Nations. See, as I mentioned earlier, so here UPSC again tend to is asking you about the nature of the organization, right? So here it is the same thing. So IUCN is not an organ of United Nations, right? Okay, so obviously this statement is wrong. So luckily, if you see the options here, if one is wrong, we have only one option, two and three, right? So whenever you're doing revision, I'm again telling you, please focus on the kind of nature of that organization, right? So obviously, we have seen that yes, CITES is legally binding. However, it does not necessarily take place in place of national laws, right? So similarly, there was another question in 2011. So this is regarding the red data books of the IUCN. So this is the kind of extension information I'm giving about the IUCN. So we have three statements here. It says endemic plant and animal species present in the biodiversity hotspot. So what does this content? This contain this is contains the endemic flora and fauna. Okay. And second one says threatened plant and animal species. Okay, this is also seems to be fine. But the see the third option, it says the sites. So protected sites for conservation of nature and natural resources in various countries. So this is not true. Okay, So red data books, it generally contains about the flora and fauna which are the endangered species. So obviously this is like a is like examiner voluntarily pushing you like pushing you some kind of information here which is not true. Okay, so obviously three is wrong. If we see if we eliminate all three, there is only one option, that is two only. So now let us see one practice MCQ here. So which among the following statements are true regarding the wildlife? So this is also a little more information you need to note down. So it's, there is one international consortium on combating wildlife crime. So what is it? The statement one says it is a collaboration between the five intergovernmental organizations, that is the CITES, Interpol, and UNODC, that stands for United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime. Here it is, right? Okay, and World Bank and World Customs Organization. Okay, so if you see this statement is right. Okay, so the second statement says the World Wildlife Crime Report 2020 is released by CITES. Sorry, is released by CITES. Okay, and the third statement says United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime lists species and are grouped in appendices according to how they are threatened in the context of international trade. See what happened is UPSC generally what does it do? If you see there are certain MCQs in which they tend to change two options interchange. Like see, actually what happened is the UNODC is the one which publishes World Wildlife Crime Report 2020. Okay, generally this one publishes, while the list of the species is given by by CITES, right? So the examiner they tend to change, like they interchange the information and try to confuse you. Okay, so this kind of MCQs are there in previous questions also. If you go through, I think you might be finding these things. So these two are wrong. The first statement is right. Oh, okay. So let us take this is one only. Okay, so only the first statement is right. So it's about international consortium and combating wildlife crime. Okay, so let us see the next topic. So this is regarding the cooperations. See, generally almost from particular to 2 to 3 years, they are asking about certain kind of alliances or certain kind of cooperations that have been formed in the context of environment or protecting the ecology, right? So these two are in news recently. So recently there was a dialogue that happened in New Delhi, right? So what are these cooperations? South-South cooperation is a collaboration among the countries of the South, right? Of the South, in political, economical, cultural, or environmental, right? So this is kind of a cooperation of South-South countries. And there is a triangular cooperation. So what does it do? These are generally a traditional donor countries and multilateral organizations that facilitate the South-South initiatives, right? So these are nothing but the these are the group that facilitate the South-South initiatives. It might be like funding or any kind of technological sharing or any kind of management oriented, right? Or skill development, any kind, right? So let us go ahead and see one questions regarding same. See, in 2017 there was a question on the alliance. See, so with reference to Global Climate Alliance, so this was an alliance formed by European Union. So in this context, it is very much important to focus on these kind of areas, right? So it is an initiative by IUCN. It's the first statement. The second statement is it provides technical and financial support to the targeted developing countries to integrate climate change into their development policies and budgets, right? This is also true. And third option is it is coordinated by World Resources Institute. This is not true, which is like voluntarily incorporated. This is supported. This alliance is supported by certain organizations like FAO, right? Food and agriculture organizations, right? But not by these. So this is wrong. So only one and two is right. So the next kind of is regarding the Basel Ban Amendment. So what happened is in 1995 there was one amendment. So what does it deal with? It deals with the global waste dumping prohibition. So what happening is like from the past like 1 or 2 decades there was even it's a bone of contention now. So it was like so there was a dumping issues between the developed countries and developing countries. If you see, for example, the most developed countries like the America has been transferring the e-waste to the African countries, which are still in the developing stage. So this is creating more and more junk in the African countries, and it is leading to the environmental pollution, right? And it leading to the degradation. So what happened is recently, by this when the Corsica, sorry, when the Croatia ratified this in 2019. So this took place as an international, as a part of international convention, right? So now this comes as a new article in this convention. For example, here I would like to bring about the Paris Agreement, where minimum of 55 countries need to sign, right? Which contribute to near about the 50 to 55% of the pollution, right? So there are certain criteria for any convention or any kind of protocol has to come into implementation. So this has come into implementation in 2019. So in this context, it is very much important. So what does this do? This amendment says, so it prohibits the export of hazardous waste, including the e-waste, etc., right? So especially from the OECD to non-OECD countries. So so this was adopted in Basel Convention 1995. So this was against the hazardous waste. And here you see India is not a member. So this is also very much important. Where does India stand in this particular kind of conventions? So please note this. So in UPSC 2019, there is one question on microbeads. So why I brought this question is here. So what happened is, in last year, there was a Basel Convention established a new working group. So this was in current affairs. That is the Plastic Waste Partnership Working Group. So here in this current affairs, in the same article, they were dealing with the plastic waste, how microbeads, which is the type of a plastic, it is contributing to the environmental degradation. Okay, so from there, we can see that simply a technical term about the technical term of microbeads has been asked. So here, microbeads are nothing but a type of small plastics. Yeah, so these plastics are generally used in our day-to-day consumables like face wash or shampoos, etc. So which helps in cleansing, right? So obviously what happening is like these microbeads are going through our drains and joining the water system and creating harm to the marine ecosystem. So the answer is A. So what I'm leading from here is you need to focus about the little bit technical information regarding any current affairs, right? So if it is on plastics, or if there was a particular topic, if there is certain new terms, please refer that. I can give one more example also. In last year or last year, they asked about about the e-waste, like e-waste and the producer responsibility. So even this has come in the MCQ, right? So the next current affairs is regarding the intergovernmental panel on climate change.